Hello and welcome to the Clock Tower quest guide. On screen now is the start. It shows the starting location. To get there, you can take the Otteron Lodestone, or you can take the quicker way using the Grand Tree after the Grand Tree quest. So let us begin. Do note that for this quest, all you will need is a bucket of water. So yeah, it is recommended that you have energy potions, and you must be able to evade level 53 ogres. So go ahead and start by talking to Brother Kojo. Hello, monk. Hello, adventurer. My name is Brother Kojo. What happened at the time? No, sorry, I don't. Exactly. The clock tower has basically been broken, and nobody can tell the correct time. He must fix it. Do you suppose I could be able to help him? Okay, what can I do? Oh, thank you. In the cellar below, you'll find four cogs. They're too heavy for me, but you should be able to carry them one at a time. I know one goes on each floor, but I can't exactly remember goes where. I'm sure you can figure it out easily already. I'll do my best. Thank you. And remember, be careful. The cellar is full of strange beasts. So head on down through the door and down the stairs. Alright, the first one I mentioned is the Walls of Fire. So, yes, head through the one that goes towards the black cog, and it should come around the area where there is a lot of fire. Note, in this area there are giant level 2 spiders, but nothing to worry about. So, as you see, the black cog is surrounded by fire here, and I'll show you what happens if you try to take it. Pour water over the cog, it quickly cools. That's what happens if you have the bucket of water in your inventory. If you didn't, you would be out of luck. Once you do that, head back to the ladder, and you should see four spindles sticking out. Use the one on the spindle to the east. Said the cog fits perfectly. Next up, head into the southeast door. This area will contain the level 53 ogres, but is not a big problem. Just quickly run in, grab the red cog, and get out of there. If you are a low level, I do suggest bringing food, because these can hurt you. As you see, I took two hits, but nothing too major. Once you do this, you'll head back up the ladder towards the ground floor and use this on the red spindle. I'll show you when I get there. Once you get up there, you'll notice the red spindle here on the north. Use it on that. It should say the cog fits perfectly. Once you do that, head on back in, and we're going to take the northwest path towards the, I guess it's the white cog. Let's go ahead and head towards that. Just go ahead and grab it. There's rat poison here. Well, we probably need to poison. So for the temporary moment, let's avoid this, and let's go ahead and hit the other path for the blue cog. And this is why you would need energy potions. Now, as you see down here, you'll notice this area is stuck in here with the dungeon rat. To get back out, head back up the ladder, out the door, and yeah, down the ladder. apologize that this is taking a moment. I will see you back up at the top. Alright, we're headed back up the stairs. So, for this one, head up towards the zoo boundary. So head up the surface, head northeast. Head northeast to the zoo boundary until you notice a ladder just south of the camel cage. There's the camel cage, and there's the ladder outside there. Following the outer edges, you'll notice a bucket and a ladder. Head down the ladder, head on through this area. And this will be a long, winding outer passage, so following the passage until it just keep following the passage until it hits a wall. Come on. There we go. And once it reaches the wall, push on the wall. You'll come out in the area that has the blue cog. So once you do that, climb on up the ladder. And you'll appear right outside the clock tower. As you see, it was blocked so you could not get in, so yes, do keep that on mind. So once you do that, head on back in here, and you're going to want to head up the stairs. And now I've got to run around this place. Hold on one moment. Once you do that, use the blue cog on the blue spindle. Once you do that, head on back down the staircase and head down again. Once you do that, you should go in, pick up the poison, and it said head around the passage that goes northeast. There should be two levers, if I'm not mistaken. I may have gotten the location wrong. Let me see. Ah, I went to the wrong spot. That's my fault. I should have went through the other passage in this area. Here you'll notice two levers. Pull them both, and you'll open up the entrance to the cage. Once you get in there, use the poison on the food trough. And you'll watch them smash against this gate and eventually die. So once you do that, head on through the gate. And head up the ladder. You'll appear right outside the entrance. Once you do that, head on back up the ladder again. Do it one more time and you'll be on the top floor. Use the white cog on the white spindle and the clock tower should be starting up. So once you do that, head on back down the staircase and talk to Brother Kojo again. He should reward you with 1 quest point, 500 coins, and 2 extra spins on the Squill of Fortune. And there we go, quest complete. This is Phonic Arts, I hope you've enjoyed.